So, hello and welcome to the finals of the UGA Kellos Division versus my good friend Lucas, aka Big Relaxo. And yeah, it was quite a while since the semifinals. Reason being is just that I recently visited my family because I visited the family of my girlfriend over the public holidays, so I did not visit my own family. And then I said, okay, when the new year arrives, I will visit you. So I wasn't able to battle, and now I'm back at home, and now I have time to battle my friend. And yeah, no team building this time, because like I built on my laptop when I was visiting my family, so I didn't make a fancy PowerPoint or something like that this time, and I didn't feel like doing so afterwards. And overall, time is just not there to also do the team building video. And to be completely honest, I think talking a little bit about the team before the match is completely fine this time. I have some, I would say, a little bit more fancy stuff this week, and let's see if I can cheese Lucas a little bit with it. In case the audio is a little bit different compared to the other times, reason being is I'm actually using my girlfriend's headset, because I had my headset when I took my headset with me to my family. And I have a wireless headset, and I stupidly forgot the USB stick, which I need to connect the headset with the computer at the house of my family. So yeah, I have to wait until it arrives back to me. So I have to use my girlfriend's headset. I mean, I did some testing with it, and she also recorded some stuff for school with it, and it was pretty all right. So I hope the audio is as good as the other times. And I don't know, Lucas takes sometimes, I don't know what he's doing there. He just messaged me, "Go like a fun." I messaged the same thing to him. And let's just hope that the battle soon starts. No, he has the rules. Okay. Yeah, building for him was not an easy task, because like I helped him a lot with his squad while drafting. And so I know, I pretty much know everything about his team, and he knows a lot about my team as well, because I always talk to him about my ideas for the other opponents. And yeah, so it wasn't as easy, but because we know each other super well. Okay, let's go over the team. Check summary. So we have Excadrill with the Ockerberry, because like Cinderace is a really big threat, and I want to take the GMAX Firebolt as good as possible, so Ockerberry is the obvious choice for me. I won Adamant and just enough speed EVs to outspeed his Cinderace, even after I dropped. For example, if I get up the Tailwind or the Sand and he Icy Winds me, I still outspeed him. So that's basically the speed investment I went for. Then I have nearly full attack investment, Adamant, because that's what I need to KO Dynamax Cinderace with Max Quake. And then I put the rest into defense with 4 on HP and 4 on special defense to take the hits from from Cinderace as good as possible. Move wise, as you can see, Protect, Earthquake, Ironhead, Rock Slide. I opted to run Earthquake instead of Housefall because I have a ground immunity and I have actually 5 Protects on my team. Actually 6 with Excadrill, so Earthquake is pretty safe. It also allows me to avoid Togetic and Ironhead for Togetic, and Rock Slide mainly for setting up the sand for me, and there was no move I really wanted over Rock Slide. Then we have Neuvern this week with Lumberry because he likes to use Scarf, Nuzzle, Toxicity if the opponent has Pokemon that are faster than Cinderace, which is the case in with Neuven. And for example, Nuzzle, Scarf, Nuzzle, and Max Move could KO me before I set up the Tailwind, and I don't want that to happen, so I run Lumberry. I run enough speed to outspeed Cinderace, and then I put the rest into bulk. I split HP and defense a bit. HP is so I take one less damage from Sand, and I still take Adamant Life Orb Max Airstream from Cinderace. And then I just put 4 into each of the remaining stats. Move wise, I have Protect, Tailwind, Draco Meteor, and one interesting move, Steering. You may think I have Steering for Togetic, but that's not the case. I have Steering for my Crossle. I know I skipped Urshifu, but I want to talk about Crossle, because Crossle is amazing versus him. Once again, Crossle has to bring the weakness policy like I used it in week 3. I have enough speed, so I outspeed Cinderace after my weak armor got procced. For example, the idea is I can just Steering my Crossle, activate the policy, get to +2 speed, and Oko Cinderace with Max Rockfall. I run Max Attack Adamant and just put 4 into both defenses and the rest into HP. And then I have Stomping Tantrum for the Toxicity and stuff like that, and Solar Blade so I can hit Blastoise with Max Grass, with Max Overgrowth. Then I have Focus Sash Urshifu. I thought about running Choice Band and Poison Jab for the Togetic, but I think with Crossle and Excadrill I should have enough to deal with Togetic. So I run Focus Sash for the extra security. I run enough speed to outspeed Jolly Sog, and then the Max Attack and 4 into both defenses and the rest into HP. And the standard moveset. Like I thought about dropping Sucker Punch for Poison Jab, but I don't know, Wicked Blow still does a decent damage versus Togetic, and Sucker Punch can be really clutch in some situations, and I really like this. Like, these three moves are pretty mandatory for Urshifu in my opinion. And yeah, then I have Citrus Berry Primarina, because this week, like, I don't feel like maxing Primarina as much, so Life Orb isn't as needed. Assault Vest isn't needed either, because he has a lot of physical threats, so I was like, okay, let's just bulk up and go Citrus Berry. I want enough speed to outspeed Cinderace when I'm at +2 speed. I want 28 HP, 28 special attack and modest to gain the extra point, and then I want like nearly full HP and a lot of defense investment to be as physical defensive as possible. And you can see I have a pretty niche moveset. I have Protect, I have Perish Song, because like if I get 2 quick KOs with Excadrill or Crossle, I can just Perish Song and win. And he has also some passive mods with Snorlax, Togetic, Blastoise, stuff like that. So I think Perish Song can be good in the endgame. Aqua Jet to have a second way to set up Crossle and just Scald to like overall deal decent damage across the board. And the last one is Meowstic with Call Barbarian, because yeah, I could run Max Darkness on like Cinderace. I have enough speed to outspeed modest max speed Blastoise, which could be brought, and then I have max HP and a lot of defense investment, like nearly full defense investment, to take Adamant, Life Orb, G-Max, Pyro Ball from Cinderace, and then I put the rest into a special attack, like 4 into special attack, 4 into special defense. Moveset Protect, because I have Perish Song on the team, and like there was not single support move I really really wanted. I have Fake Out to match the Blastoise Fake Out. I have Tickle to combo with my Excadrill. For example, I can Tickle the Incineroar, not Incineroar, the Togetic, and KO it with Max Rockfall. I can weaken the Cinderace and Psychic just to deal with Sog and Toxicity and stuff like that. Yeah, why didn't I bring like Charizard? Like Charizard isn't really good. It's also not really bad, but he could run Assault Vest, like Tick-Tat, Snorlax, and his Blastoise. It's really not super good with Cinderace, and these are just reasons why I didn't feel like Charizard is the call. Even though I would really like to bring it in the finals, but I don't want to force it. Like Thraki is really bad versus Cinderace, and But the Snorlax is not really good either. Like, yes, he has also toxicity. Yes, he has so many grass resists, and overall, it doesn't do enough. Electric, he doesn't have a really threatening electric type Pokemon, and Electric just doesn't do much here overall. What didn't I bring either? Trevenant. Like, Trevenant has similar problems which Thraki has, and I don't really want to set up Trick Room, so Trevenant isn't really worth to me. Like, I thought about bringing it versus like Trick Room stuff with Snorlax, but I think like Bishop and Cinderace threatened it way too much to bring it. And what's Blissey? I didn't bring Blissey because he has Sork, he has Cinderace, he has Bishop. Way too many physical threats for Blissey to take care of. And what's the last mon I'm missing? Am I really missing a mon? Let me think real quick. I have to miss 5, right? Charizard, Thraki, Manectric, Blissey. No, I mentioned all of them. So yeah, that's the team. And yeah, now just let's see what Lucas brings to the table. Yeah, we go with Legend 1. I really like Legend 1. Let's see. Okay. Pretty much what I expected, but Gorgas. I didn't expect Gorgas too much. So he has a Trick Room mode with Togetic, Gorgas, Snorlax. I would have really liked to see to not see Blastoise, to be honest. But I think that's fine. I think I want to lead. Like, Neuven is really good to scout the items, but if he leads Trick Room, it's a little bit awkward. Like, maybe Excadrill Meowstic? I don't get to scout the items, but I think that's fine. What else do I bring? Like, I think Urshifu is still good because of Snorlax, and Snorlax could be really annoying. But then I have to deal with Togetic really, really quickly. Primarina is really decent here. I don't think I will bring Crossle game 1. And I don't like Neuven in the back. I think we tried this the first game. And let's see, if he leads Trick Room game 1 and he loses, then I will definitely bring Crossle game 2. Because Cross is really good versus everything but the Trick Room lead. Let's see, that's a really scary matchup. Because he has so many lead options, I assume. But I think with Meowstic, Excadrill, we have a decent matchup across the board. There's the Trick Room matchup. I assume this Gourgeist has Trick Room, Will-O-Wisp, Leech Seed stuff. He can scout the items, which is sad for me, but that's fine. I could have led Meowstic Urshifu, right? But I think he has Culberberry anyways. I'm thinking about, like, I mean, I could just Iron Head Tickle the Togetic. I mean, he could protect, right? I could also just tickle Iron Head the Pumpkin. I think that's a little bit better. Because Togetic most likely protects. And if not, he follows me anyway. Yeah, he protects. So, great turn 1. We get to see how much damage we do. I didn't max because I think he will survive anyway. And next turn he can just burn me, and I don't want that to happen. Also, by not targeting Togetic, he doesn't get Eject Pack. What? What on earth is he running? That's really unique. Okay, but that's good to know because he has no Cobra Ray then. The reason why I didn't target Togetic is if he sets up Trick Room and I KO Togetic, he has a free switch into Snorlax, and I don't want that to happen. I assume like Snorlax or Blastoise is in the back. I don't see Toxicity or Cinderace Arc coming when he goes for Trick Room. Assuming he has Trick Room. Okay, Cinderace is coming in. But he doesn't take that too well, right? Yeah. I do good damage. Let me think. Like, max Deerspike into Togetic is really, really free right now. But I could also like max Rockfall, I assume, to set up the sand, so I outspeed the Cinderace next turn. I think I want to go for that a little bit more. Yeah, and just like tickle the Cinderace so it deals less damage. Doesn't max. Okay. Okay, then I think he has Snorlax in the back for sure. But as I said, if we take two KOs somehow quick, we should be good. Helping Hand, oh. But I don't think he can. Maybe Helping Hand High Jump Kick could KO me. But I have Tickle, so I don't think he will KO me, right? But that still will hurt. That will certainly hurt. Iron Head. Okay. I will take that for sure. Yeah, easy. Okay, it's Life Orb. So it's not Support Cinderace. That's also really good to know. This turn. Like, even if he protects, I should KO him with Max Deerspike. So Max Deerspike is super safe. It's just, what do I do with Meow Stick? Like, I could just tickle the Cinderace, I guess. Because then it really doesn't deal a whole lot of damage. I could also just switch into Primarina. Or I could switch into Urshifu. Because with the plus one defense and him being minus one attack, he shouldn't do too much damage, right? And Urshifu would threaten the pumped the Gourgeist, right? Yeah, I think that's what I need to go for. He stays in, okay, that's good. I mean, that's fine, I guess. Urshifu comes in, he switches Togetic out. Everything will take good damage. Snorlax. Okay, Snorlax doesn't enjoy taking the max Deerspike, and I can post combat that slot. Like, he has two good switch ins, but wow, that deals a lot of damage. Holy shit, that deals so much damage. That's really good. Okay, it's Barry. Cetrus, I assume? Cetrus. And there's the coaching, okay. So he has Life Orb and he has coaching. Okay, that's cool. But the thing is, like, I'm plus one defense with both. And I have a very free max Deerspike into Cinderace. And I think I will just close combat to Snorlax. Because I know he has two switch-ins, but next turn Excadrill threatens both of them, right? Yeah, and I want to cover him doing something with Snorlax. Like, Wicked Plug would be decent as well, but I really want to get rid of Snorlax if possible. I should get a free KO into the Cinderace, but either way. Assuming he does not have Protect. But even then, like, I get a KO next turn. Snorlax maxes, but like, I will be at plus 2 defense with both, so it shouldn't take a KO, I assume. I mean, Urshifu won't be at plus 2, right? Oh, ally switch, what? Oh, ally switch. Huh, that's cheesy, that's really cheesy. Okay, so we won't deal as much damage with Snorlax. Yeah, that really didn't do a whole lot. But as soon as we get two KOs, he has Pumpkin and Togetic, which shouldn't really beat me. Okay, we get the KO, that's really, really good. Because next turn we can KO, we can just double target Snorlax, I assume. And I will go for Wicked Blow because I fear the The allies had done pumped him. I mean, Gorgas, sorry for pronouncing the German name. Like, pumped him just really sounds so English to me. Max Knuckle was a good play, by the way. But Snorlax shouldn't be able to KO Excadrill next turn. So Excadrill, if he brings the Togetic, Excadrill can just Iron Head that slot, while Snorlax gets KO'd by Close Combat. So I think he has to bring in Gorgas. Like, Togetic is not a play. It's really not the play, I think. And then it's a question of whether or not Snorlax takes Close Combat. I don't think it will. Yeah, Pumpkin is the correct play. I'm really fearing the ally switch. Anyway, I will Wicked Blow the Pumpkin because I really don't want Trick Room to get set up. So I could also just double target that slot just in case the ally switches. I think that's what I will do. Because this really pins down the Pumpkin. Okay, no ally switch. So I assume he wants to set up the Trick Room. But I denied the Trick Room now. And if he takes the KO, I will just perish the next game. And next turn. And I don't think he can KO Excadrill, so Togetic is in Iron Head range next turn. Like, he gets second, like a third attack boost, which could be scary, but I can just, like I said, set up the Parish Song and then just protect and fake out stall him, and there shouldn't be a way that he can win at this point. Let me think about it. A Parish Song, he brings in Togetic, he most likely protects. But I don't think he can KO Excadrill. Even if he does, the turn afterwards, I can just fake out the Snorlax. Then I can double protect. I don't think he can win. Like, I really don't think he can. Right, I set up Parish Song next turn, I fake him out. I don't think he can win. Do I protect? I could protect Excadrill. Because I think he has to target Excadrill, right? Because if he doesn't target Excadrill, like, he's just completely screwed. I will protect Parish Song. Because I think he, like, Snorlax shouldn't be KO'd by Excadrill. So I think he can afford to not follow me this turn. And then follow me next turn. And I don't think he targets Pumarine. And even if he does, like, it should be fine. Because next turn I can just fake out Snorlax, Iron Head, Togetic, and win from there. Yeah, there's the protect. And now he shouldn't be able to win, because next turn I will just KO Togetic, I will fake out the Snorlax, and then he shouldn't be able to win. Max Strike should not matter. I don't think that will KO. What am I talking? He's plus 3, of course this will KO. Okay. But this should secure me game 1. Right? I mean, if he KOs Meowstic, I lose to Parish Song, because the slowest mon wins. But I will just fake out the Snorlax, KO Togetic, and then there shouldn't be a way for him to win. Next game I will go for Neuvern Cross Elite. He gets a double protect. Like, oh, this could change something, right? Because if he KOs Meowstic, I could be screwed, right? That's not good. the double really annoys me. What am I doing here? Ironhead? Does he expect to project? Like, does he target Excadrill? I'm not sure if this is the right play. Okay, this is the right play. Okay. I don't know if this KOs. I mean, I get rid of the defense boost. I really hope this KOs. Okay, great. Ooh, this was so scary. If I protected, like, without the defense boost, I wouldn't without the tickle, I wouldn't KO the Snorlax. Then I could lose. So I'm glad I didn't protect in the end. I don't know why I went for Psychic. Now I revealed a move for no reason. Wait a second. Do I even beat Togetic in a 1v1 with Meowstic? What am I talking? He just drops the Parish, right? Yeah, of course he does. Okay. Whew, super close. Super close. So glad that I put Parish on Primarina. Oh god, Snorlax is so scary. Like, now it's a prediction. Does he go for the Trick Room lead once again? Like, I could. If I predict the Trick Room lead, I could just go for Meowstic Urshifu. But I think he wants to change something. Right? Like, he has to, I think. I want to go to the Neuvern Cross Elite. With Primarina. Urshifu from the back? Or maybe Meowstic. Or Excadrill? Excadrill could be really good as well. Because I set up the sand for Excadrill. But without Urshifu, like. I don't know. Without Urshifu, late game. Gourgaz could be a little bit annoying. Snorlax could be a little bit annoying, I assume. Just Excadrill is so good versus this team. It's really so good. I think I want to go with Excadrill. There are a couple of ways this lead could go wrong, but I'm one game up, and I don't think he will expect this, so I just want to try it. Let's see. Okay, I can scout the items, so that's something. I assume Scarf, no, Toxicity. Shy Scarf, Toxicity, Quick Claw, not, what the heck? I think I would just double protect, I assume. I could also switch out into Excadrill. And go late game Crosser. Thing is, he could scald the Crosser slot. No, I don't. I want to protect. Next time I will just Steering Crosser, Max Quake, the Toxicity, and play around the. No, I don't. I don't Steering myself. I will just Tailwind, because if he scores, then he activates my weakness policy anyway. What the heck? That's really scary. But I will just Tailwind. And I will Like, I could just attack the Snorlax, I saw. Maybe that's better, because next time I will outspeed the Toxtricity anyways. Yeah, I think that's better, weakening the water sport. I'm really glad that I have Lamberry on the Neuvern. The only bad part is that Crossle won't outspeed without Scarf Toxtricity without the weak armor boost as well. Okay, he just nuzzles. I'm so glad I dropped the Yachi Berry for Lumberry. Because now I just set up the Tailwind. I have a really strong max Rockfall for the rest size. I didn't go for max Overgrowth because I don't think it will KO, and max Rockfall sets up. What the heck? Was that a crit? That has to be a crit, right? Yeah. There's no way this would have KO'd otherwise. I mean, 150 base for is super strong. I don't know how bulky this Bastard is, but I think even without any investment, I shouldn't Oko Blastoise. So I'm very sorry for that. Okay, let's see what he brings in. Snorlax. Okay, now I think my play is just steering myself to activate the weak armor and just do I max Quack? Like, I could switch into Togetic, I assume, so I will just max Rock for the Tox. Although Tox is not a threat, right? But I don't want my Crossle to get nuzzled. Yeah, I just want to KO the Tox. Steel Wind activates, weak armor, super good. Plus 2 speed. Now we outspeed the Tox, we activate our weakness policy. And we just crush this Toxtricity right now. 150 base for max Rockfall. Get out of it. Bye bye. This is so funny. I really love my boy Crossle. He always just comes and cleans up. Okay, Curse. Curse is scary. But I will just switch out Neuvern for Primarina and Perishstone. And KO whatever he brings in next to Snorlax with my Crossle. I don't think Snorlax can knock out Primarina, even with plus 1. I don't think he can. Togetic. I think Togetic will protect, but there's no point in targeting Snorlax because, like, Snorlax with the defense boost will just take my hit anyways. So I will just target the Togetic in case he had in hands. So max Rockfalling Snorlax last time would have won me the game, I assume, because I think plus 2 max Rockfall would have failed. But I feared him like Dynamaxing and then taking the hit and so, and stuff like that. So I just wanted to take the safe KO, because I knew that this Tox couldn't protect, so whatever was in that slot would go down to the plus 2 max Rockfall and then I have to perish endgame. The thing is, if he targets the Neuvern slot, predicting the switch in, I could be a little bit screwed. Because I don't know if... with helping hand, he should KO the Primarina, but without, I don't think he can KO me. There's the Protect. And next time I will just perish. Next Rockfall should do like 30, I assume. Yeah, 40, 35, 40, something like that. Max Knuckle, okay, we should win now, because we will just Perish Song now. I will just Perish Song and Rock Wrecker the Togetic. Yeah, I'm really glad that the Neuwen Cross Elite worked out so, so well. And also the Parish Primarina. Like, those were the two cheesy strats I've planned the whole time. And luckily they paid off big time. I also went for Rockwrecker because without Rockwrecker, like, Max Rockfall isn't strong enough to KO Togetic without a boost. And I really wanted to make sure to KO the completely defensive Togetic. And Rockwrecker is a really cool animation, so I was like, if I can click Rockwrecker, let's go for it. Look at it, it's so cool. It's so fucking cool. Bye bye Togetic, Trussel is too strong. I really like that, like, Trussel came with 3, completely destroyed. Then I dropped him because he wasn't good versus the other opponents I would face. And then I dropped Pillow Spine for Trussel because, like, I just thought, like, Pillow Spine doesn't do anything, and, like, Trussel is always a threat. It's like a cheap Colossal in some regard. And yeah, if he can do work, he does a lot of work, as you can see. At this point, it really doesn't matter what I bring in, because I would just double protect each turn that's possible. Yeah, that's why that's why you always have to have 6 protects if possible when you go for Perish stuff, because this makes stalling out the Perish so much easier. Oh, I should not have protected because he will target the Crusher anyway. This was a misplay by me, but I don't think it will matter, to be completely honest. No, this really shouldn't matter. Because he can only take 1 KO each turn. And the last turn, when he's outside of Dynamax, I can just protect him and he's screwed. So this shouldn't matter at all. Yeah, he has only 2 turns left and he has no spread move because it's Dynamaxed. So this turn I won't protect with either, because this could screw me up. I will just double attack. Oh, Dynamax is over right now. But there's no move he could have, right? Like, he could have... I will steal him for the defense boost. And Iron Head. Like, he could have Earthquake, but this won't affect Neuwen, and if he Rockslides, this won't KO Excadrill. And there's no other spread move that Snorlax gets. Like, he gets Surf and Blizzard, but he won't run those two, of course. So I don't think my misplay last turn matters in the end. I don't go for Draco because I don't need damage, I just need to survive the turns. Double Edge, of course, gets the KO, but this does not matter because I did not protect. And now I will just protect Excadrill and he will go down to Perish them. And yeah, I'm really happy that I finally was able to bring my Perish them Primarina. I theorized it a lot, but it was never really strong, but this week it's really, really good. Yeah, good game to Lucas. Both games were super close, to be honest. It's like both games, like, especially game one, if he makes the call and, like, I don't know, I think that was winnable for him. Like, game one was definitely winnable. Game two, like, the crit on Blasters was super unfortunate. But I don't think it matters too much in the long run, because, like, Blaster would have been really low. He would have activated policy. I most likely could have went for a double KO by Max Rock Falling Tox and Draco Meteor the Blastoise. I then can go for Perish Song Endgame as well. I don't think it matters too much. But this sucks, of course. Of course this sucks. And I don't want to say that it didn't matter, because it could have mattered. I don't know what his game plan was for game 2, but yeah, luckily I called him going for Trick Room game 1 and not going Trick Room again game 2, because Neuwen Crosser would have been super bad versus Togetic, and Gorgoy stuff. Because like I can KO Togetic and it's not as if Source Snorlax doesn't do a whole lot versus Crossle. But the thing is, I think he has Will-O-Wisp, so he can just burn me, then I won't KO the Gourgaiz, and Gourgaiz could also have like grass moves, and then I don't set up the Perish Song and stuff like that. So that would have been a really bad scenario for me. And yeah. Oh no, we won the Kalos division. I don't know which winner of the other divisions we face in the grand playoffs, but I'm very happy about my season. Like I didn't achieve the perfect season. Like I lost week 10, but my goal was to win this league, at least make it to the grand playoffs, and I achieved that. And my second goal was just to play versus my good friend in the finals, and I also achieved that. And yeah, GG's to Lucas. I really hope to face you next season as well. I know that he will play. And yeah, also check out his channel. I will link his channel and of course his side of our match in the description, so you can see what his thought process was. And I will check that out for sure, because I want to see his reaction when I click Perish Song, and I want to see his reaction to the Lumberry Neuvern and the side steering stuff. I really want to see his reaction. I think he did not expect that at all. And yeah, as always, thanks for watching. Stay healthy. If you like the content, please leave a like. May subscribe. And let me know in the comments what you thought about the battle and maybe about the whole season of the UGA. And yeah, as always, goodbye, and I see you on the next video.